Well, this very awkward setup here is me receiving a weather satellite. I think it's NOAA 18. Let's see, 27.9125. Yes, that's right. That's a quadrifilla helix antenna that I newly built, and it is working brilliantly. I'm really impressed with it. I had absolutely no idea it would work this good. I was actually intended to receive Meteor M1 because there's some reports saying that it's actually come back to life, but I couldn't find its signal. But later on I'll be able to receive Meteor M2 and that should hopefully work. I've tried doing it with the fishing rod style antenna and it just wasn't working. The signal was just too weak. I might actually get a few lines of image and that was it. The Meteor satellites use LRPT, which compared to APT is actually much higher resolution. But that's doing brilliantly. Quite happy with that. I shall decode this image later on and I'll show you what it looks like. But I have been getting brilliant images from it. And the strong signal you get there is actually just pagers. I think they're used by the emergency services now only. I've decoded them before and it's just like ambulance incidents. I'm just recording the audio using the program itself. The SDR that I'm using, by the way, is just an R820T21. It's a new one that I got with a metal enclosure. And it's a little bit more sensitive, so I've read. I'd certainly believe that claim anyway, because that coupled with the new antenna is resulting in excellent performance. The signal's beginning to die away now, because NOAA 18 is on a south to north pass, so it's probably away over there someplace. A little bit about the antenna connector. I actually used the one that came with this unit, and I just cut the connector off and soldered on the RG58 coaxial and put a load of glue around it. So it's made a really nice connection. Yeah, that signal's dying away now. But what I'll do is eventually I will replace that with an SMA connection, and I'll put an SMA connection in the unit itself. That should be a little bit better. I don't know what the connection on it is called that's on it just now, but it's very small. Another issue is if you have power line networking, that causes a lot of interference. I'll show you just now. So that's power line networking on now. It should come up. Here, look at all the spikes that came up there. So yeah, it's quite a big problem in certain frequencies. All the satellites must be above me today because that's NOAA 15 just coming there just now, so that's another image I'll be getting. So this image here was my first test with the quadrifilla helix, and unfortunately I'd flung together a connection and I was dropping the signal now and again because the connection to the SDR was quite rubbish. So this is the NOAA 18 image that I got, and that was just out there previously in the video, the first image, and it's a really nice clear image. Zoom in a bit, that's the actual size, so it's a nice image there. This was just one I got from NOAA 18 previously today, and that's the one that I got just there just now in the video from NOAA 15. With a bit of a weak pass, I think. And this is from the 6th, this was earlier, this is when I had my fishing rod antenna, and as you can see the quality is quite poor as you move it around, but still usable.